And welcome to yet another episode of One Credit Champ, the show where a 43-year-old clinically depressed man bets his self-esteem on YouTube in the vain hope that the people watching will think his shitty little videos have any kind of worth. What are we playing today? And today's gamer is Shackled, so credit in, press start, and let's party like it's a year with a 9 at the end. So yes indeed, Shackled, made in 1986 by Data East. We play either Sir Aoki, or Kevin, if the internet is to be believed, usually isn't, or the second player, Bubba, and we have to traverse what can be best described as a bit of a gauntlet affair. Top down, check. Hordes of badmans, check. Have to get to an exit like that. Check. But Data East couldn't leave it that fine and dandy. Did you see what I did there? No? Never mind. No, they decided to add 6 other characters, held prisoner behind doors that can change your projectile attack at the press of a button. They walk behind you in shackles, hence the name, function as a second firing character or option in shoot 'em up parlance, and are an absolute pig to control due to the way they follow behind you a few steps yet immediately react to your joystick input. It's a little hard to explain, but often due to the way they follow, expect them to just get stuck behind a wall. At the end of the stage, those prisoners are freed and you're off to start again on the next level, which is a little different to how it's done in the Japanese version. Firstly, that version isn't called Shackled. It's called Braywood, and the character you start as, and note I say start as, doesn't have a name, and the prisoners you free are not shackled. Pressing the button to change attack type actually completely switches your character. The characters you have following you carry over to the next level, and you can swap out any member of your party, including the initial dagger-throwing guy, if you find something better behind a door. Also, the level designs begin to differ from about level 3 in. All these differences make Braywood feel like an easier, actually no, not easier, more forgiving game. Now the question is, as it usually is, what about the home ports? Tell us about the home ports. There must be home ports, I want to know, so I can emulate a vastly inferior version playing on vastly inferior hub. Okay. Okay, pipe down. Yes, there were. Oh, climb! Oh, I fucking hate clowns. The question is, what is the appropriate weapon? The circles kill the projectiles but rarely get to him. Ah, there we go. Unexpected moment of chorophobia over. Let's talk about those home ports then. And yes, there were. There were some by US Gold, no less. A sign of quality, if there ever was one. Shackled was released on Spectrum, Commodore 64, Amstrad CPC, and Atari ST. No Amiga, because Amigas are shit. As were all the ports, not really a good version between them, and a slow and often jerky mess. Even the ST version, and I put some time into that, God knows why, it would have been an utter waste of a floppy disk if it hadn't have been for Deflector being on the same crack disk. Oh, piracy. Anyway, that was it for the home versions of Shackled, which seems quite odd when you think how active Data East were on the NES at the time. I can only assume any possible NES release of Shackled was probably nixed due to the limits Nintendo put on third-party publishers, limiting them to 5 titles a year unless you pulled a Konami and created shell companies as a secondary publishing label to get away with it. Was that it? That stage was a bit easy, wasn't it? Ever get the feeling you just missed a whopping great big secret hidden room? Oh well, oh shit, I know where we are now. These guys lob a shit ton of what appears to be dynamite. I've got less than 150 health left, and it's only going to take a couple of hits before I'm dead, and all I have are these fucking daggers. If only this was the Japanese version of the game and I came into the stage with backup, eh? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and I'm dead. Well, I guess that's it. The bum has been entered, and all I can do is wait for the old continue countdown to go down. If it does go down, do I have to press another button? Ah, yes, I do. Oops. If only there had been a way to avoid those dynamite-throwing bastards. An easier way to escape this shackled dungeon. Yeah, I could have done that, but that doesn't make for an entertaining video, does it? Christ, that would have made for a quicker runtime than Special Project Y, for crying out loud. Until next time.